Yeah, so, hi, my name's Marty. Obviously, no, my name's Marty, I didn't have to say that. I'm a carpenter and a joiner and a machinist with roughly 20 years experience. I've spent a huge amount of that 20 years working in the kitchen installation industry, and through looking at the products and the types of things that I've made over the years in regards to wardrobes, kitchen parts and stuff like that, that's kind of what led me onto the CNC. Before SmartBench, it's all been portable power tools and hand tools. So predominantly to make any formwork like I would do profile cuts with, a SmartBench would have all been done with a jigsaw, a rail saw, and a palm router predominantly. There's been lots of projects where a CNC would have been preferable over the years, and if it was absolutely necessary, myself personally, I used to turn the work away. I was always actually quite scared of the idea of CNC in regards to outsourcing because of cost, availability, you know, knowing somebody in the industry. And as well, it would always been around the, you know, the limited quantities that I would be working with. A big company, you know, I'd pay a lot of money to have those plans built. So I always was just too scared and stayed away from it, to be honest. One of the biggest personal drivers in the end to purchase SmartBench over everyone else is how complete the kit is, with the touchscreen console, the touch plate, everything being built into that one package, was the biggest selling point for me. That I'm new to CNC, so to learn how to make my own software to make different things work was just not a viable option. Very, very quickly, using all of the resources online, I used all of the YouTube channel videos of Ed, say, making the 3D lizard out of Corian. You know, it was a great help with the fact that he'd gone to the time to make the video of the software, and it made things just so much easier, you know, just so much easier and more fluid than to actually understand the very basics of VCarve. So I'm a member of the Yeti Tool Facebook talk group, and again, it's unlike a lot of the other Facebook groups that I come across, in the reason of everyone's so friendly, they're also willing to share advice, and they're also willing to help. Out of all the smart benches is sold, there's more and more of a growing capacity of members actually coming back and displaying their work, which is really nice. We're not all keeping what we do as a best kept secret. We're starting to, you know, share experiences now. And I've got to be honest, as part of the Yeti package, it's just totally, you know, invaluable to me. So some of the things I've made on SmartBench would be very basic 2D cuts to develop wall art. I've made then 2.5D cuts, done as V carves and profile cuts to make bigger sign work. I've done a lot of V carved in regards to sort of entranceway signs and different things like that. And I'm starting to move now into more making jigs and squares and, you know, moving to the accuracy parts. I've been looking at more intricate projects like boxes and stuff like that. So that's, you know, the types of projects I make. So my most enjoyable is the big oak signs. Okay, so with those big oak signs, I create pocket reliefs then to take away big amounts of material. Standardly, I'd use sort of 25 and 20 mil flat bottom sort of surfacing cutters. And that hogs out the material. From there, my new favorites have been the solid carbide straight cutters. As a carpenter, I kind of can't get away from them, and they make more sense to me than what spiral end mills do, but I'm sure I'll get out of that. And then I move on to different things like replaceable tipped V-carve cutters, or the sort of, you know, few times use disposable type tungsten wing cutters. And that's what I use them for the detail work. And that's kind of like my workflow, really. Before SmartBench, there's no way on this planet I would have attempted these signs. You know, I've done a fair bit of hand carving and spoon carving and green woodwork. However, to process by hand the sizes and scales I'm able to do with SmartBench, I just wouldn't have even entertained before. So, you know, I've got to thank SmartBench for that. It's made that possible. A few installments of SmartBench Academy have really helped me and given me confidence. And I hope to grow with the SmartBench Academy and kind of complete off all of the steps that the Yeti tool is offering for me as a CNC user to help me with that, being a more rounded CNC, you know, producer. If I could give myself some advice from before I bought SmartBench, it would be, why didn't I buy a SmartBench right at the beginning? Buying a SmartBench, in all honesty, like most people, was a big decision, but I'm actually kicking myself that I didn't do this years ago. That's the bit I regret.